Good morning, students. In today's class, let us discuss about interfacing of LCD to 8051. You can see lot of applications that have been using LCD as part of the circuit. Whenever the instrument has to display some information, normally they go for either LED or LCD. Right? So, as you can see in this diagram, you can find lot of applications pertaining to various fields having LCD as part of the display. It could be your four-wheeler, it could be the CNC machine which has been used in the lathe, okay. It could be an electronic weighing scale, could be a smart watch which operates almost all the people use. People have become more health conscious of it, okay. It could be the digital multimeter which you have been using in the lab, and the microwave oven which we use in the kitchen, or it could be a glucometer used for measuring the glucose level of a diabetes 2 patients, right? So in all these devices, there is something common, right? That is nothing but the LCD display, right? This is just to infer you and to tell you the various fields in which you can, or various applications, appliances where you can find the LCD. Okay, that tells us how important is that with respect to the real-time environment. Okay, whenever you are designing any system, students, okay, if at all you have to convey the information to the customer, you need to use LCD as part of the circuit. Right? Now, as such is a requirement, it is very essential for us to know how to interface LCD to 8051. If you understand how to interface LCD to 8051, it would not be a tough job for you to understand how to interface LCD to any microcontroller that you have been using in the real-time requirement. Right? Now, with these prerequisites, let's move on. Now, coming to the various displays, there are various displays which have been used in the real-time environment. Right? And among all, LCD and LCD find lot of applications, okay, and LCD finds it more popular compared to LED because of its own features, okay. So LCD is much cheaper compared to LED, right, and you will be able to display a few numbers and characters and graphics which you are not able to display using LED, right. So, incorporation of refreshing circuitry in LCD relieves the CPU from the task of refreshing the LCD. Okay, whereas if at all you are using LED, you need to keep on refreshing the display. So, most of the time your CPU is engaged in keeping that LED refreshed. Right? And that has been taken care in case of LCD. And it is very easy to program the LCD, right? You just need to send the ASCII characters, you will be able to display the characters of your requirement, right? So these are the benefits that you get if at all you are using LCD in place of LED, right? Let us see how does the LCD look like. This is how the LCD display looks like, okay? So here you will have two rows, okay? And you will be having 16 columns. This 2 plus 16 indicates you have 2 rows and you will be able to display 16 characters. Right? And these are the pin configuration of any LCD that is available in the market. Right? And this is ground pin plus 5 volts. You will be able to vary the contrast by connecting a potentiometer between VSS, VCC, and the midpoint of the potentiometer would have been connected to the VEE. That is nothing but the contrast adjust. So by varying the potentiometer, you will be able to vary the contrast, right? And we do have a pin called RS. This RS stands for register select, okay? When we are dealing with LCD, we need to give certain commands, okay? Like where exactly we are going to start the display, okay? Are we going to display the characters in the first row or in the second row, and how we want the character to be displayed, whether we want the character to be displayed from left to right or from right to left. There are various options by which we'll be able to display. Okay, now how are you going to tell the LCD that this is how we want the characters to be displayed? For that, there is a register called command register. Okay, now to activate the command register, we need to send appropriate signal to the command register. The signal can be sent through the pin called register select. Okay, if register select pin is 0, it means that I am using the register for command. On the other hand, if the register select pin is 1, it means that I have been using register for sending the data. Right? Okay. So, say for example here, in this particular display that we can consider, here we have displayed, this is a 2x16 line LCD display. Right? In this case, we have selected both the rows. Is it not? For selecting both the rows for displaying, there is a command that has to be sent. That where are you going to write? That will be written in the command write. To do that process, we have to use the register select for command. Okay, that time you have to make RS0. On the other hand, if you have to display the information, this is a 2x16 line LCD display, then this is the data I want to be displayed on the LCD. That time I have to make RS pin 1. Students, I think this has helped you to have a little bit of understanding about how to use the RS pin. Right? In addition to that, we do have read/write. Okay, and this is actually read/write bar. Whenever we are reading the data from LCD, the bit has to be made, the pin has to be made 1. When we write the data, the pin has to be made low. Right? And here we have enable pin. Okay, that is for enabling the LCD. And if at all the LCD has to understand that you are going to enable the LCD and you are going to further function with the LCD, then the enable has to be high for certain duration. Okay, let us see what is the duration for which it is expected to be high. Right? And we do have the pins D0 to D7. Okay, D0 to D7 are the pins in which you are going to use the data. Right? And we do have backlight plus 5 volts and VB0 backlight ground. Right? So now coming to the commands that could be given to the LCD. Okay, there are around 18 commands that you can give to LCD. Okay, you do not need to buy hard these students, this is for your reference. Whenever you are interfacing LCD to 8051, you can take the command instructions. It will be available in the data sheets of LCD and you will be able to use it according to your requirement. Now, so say for example, before sending any information to the LCD, we do not want the LCD to display the previous content, whatever it had displayed. Okay, so during such occasions, what we do, we send 01 to clear the display. And the character, we expect the character to be displayed from the beginning. So we send 02 so that it will start from the, we also call it carriage return, right? From the very first character. And how we are going to move the cursor, whether we move the cursor to the left or right, okay? That could be decided by giving the appropriate commands, right? And similarly, as I said, whether you are going to use two lines, okay? And where are you going to display, whether you are going to display the character in the first line or second line, or you want to use both the lines, all those things could be decided by using the appropriate hex codes that has been given in this particular table. Right? Now, this is the hardware circuit in which we are going to interface LCD to 8051. Right? As I said, we have D0 to D7 pins of LCD which have been connected to the port 1. Okay? The register select has been connected to port 2.0. Read/write bar has been connected to port 2.1. And enable has been connected to port 2.2. Okay, as I said, we have got a potentiometer here which has been connected between VCC and ground. The midpoint has been connected to VEE. By varying the potentiometer, you will be able to vary the contrast. Right? And this is this LED minus has been grounded, and this LED plus has been connected to positive power supply, right? So these four, 2.0, 2.1 and 2.2, they are the control signal for the LCD, okay? Whereas D0 to D7 will carry the data lines, right? Now, so this is the same diagram, right? A simplified diagram of the same, okay? And this table shows how the various pins of the LCD have been used, right? Now, coming to the programming part, whenever you want to program LCD with certain characters, with certain display, the very first thing we have to do is we have to initialize LCD. So we will switch on the LCD, we wait for 15 milliseconds, okay? So that is the time required for the LCD to get initialized. As soon as you give the power, it takes some time to refresh its internal circuitry, and we need to wait for a duration of 15 milliseconds. Okay, then we send 38. Okay, this 38 has been sent to initialize 2-line 5x8 matrix, and we are going to use this in 8-bit mode. Okay, and then we have to send the display on command. The display on command could be 0E or 03. So where did we take all these things? See here. 38 is for 2-line 5x7 matrix. Okay, we have 0E or 0C, which will say the display has to be on. So you can make the display on either by cursor off or by keeping the cursor blinking. That is left to your choice, students. Okay. Then what we do? We clear the display. I said there will be some content that will be there in the LCD. It might be because of the previous content that could have been displayed earlier. So you have to clear the display. Then you send 06 for incrementing the cursor. After the first character is displayed, we expect the cursor to move to the next row, right? So for that we send the command 06, right? So this is the initialization part. Now to do this initialization, we have to write the appropriate codes. It could be your 38 or 0E or 01 or 06. Whatever the codes that we want to write, whatever the commands that we want to write, that has to be written in the command register. Okay, so how will you do that? How will you write the values into the command register? For that, there is a subroutine called command write. Okay, what are you expected to do within that subroutine? Is first, you send the command to the data port. Okay, I said, if at all you have to do something with command, you have to make the RS bit pin 0, okay? So make RS pin low. Then you are going to write the data to tell LCD that you are going to write some data into LCD. You have to make read slash write pin 0. Then you have to enable the LCD, okay? I said, students, enable pin has to be high for a minimum duration of 450 nanoseconds. Okay, here we do not need to wait for any delay, because when I set the instruction set bit enable, it's a instruction which will take only one machine cycle. Execution of one machine cycle will take minimum 1 microsecond, right? Even if at all I'm using 12 megahertz crystal, so I don't need to wait for a delay. So if I say set bit enable, that will fulfill the requirement, right? No point in having further subroutine for waiting for delay and other things, right? This is about the sending command. Then we have a subroutine for writing the data. Once we initialize the LCD as per your requirement, once we tell LCD how many rows we have been using and how are we expecting the cursor to move on, whether we want the data to be displayed from left to right or from right to left, once we tell LCD about all these prerequisites, we can start displaying the actual content. Okay, how are we going to display the actual content? Whatever you want to display, say if I want to display ATME College of Engineering, I will send ATME College of Engineering on the data port, only one character at a time. Okay, and to do so, what we have to do? Now we have to make the register selector pin high. When I make RS pin high, okay, the LCD understands that we have been using the register for sending the data, right? Then once we do that, now what are we trying to do? We are going to send the data onto the LCD. For that, I am going to make read slash write pin low because we are writing the information. Then once again, we are enabling the chip for a duration of 450 nanosecond by just setting the bit, right? After we do this, we will be going back to step 3, and if at all you have to change the mode of presenting the information, right? So this is the algorithm of the LCD students. Okay, now coming to the program. Okay, see here, this is the algorithm. We will start with the initialization of LCD. Okay, I said we have to start with the command. We have to send 38, okay, 0E0106, and this has to be through command write subroutine, right? Now, what is the first instruction? Move A comma as 38. This initializes LCD for 5 plus 7 matrix. We are calling the subroutine command. We are waiting for some delay. Then we send 0E. As I said, you can send either 0E or 0C. Then we are clearing the display by giving move A,01. Then we are moving the cursor towards right. In between all these commands that we are giving, we are calling a subroutine called command. In that command, what are we trying to do? Okay, here there was an algorithm for this command. What was the algorithm? Send command to data port, make RS is equal to 0, make R slash read slash write bar 0, then make enable high. Okay, this is the subroutine program that was supposed to be written. Right, here is the algorithm. Let us see whether our program matches the algorithm. Okay, we have sent the data to port 1. We have cleared port 2.0. We made RS is equal to 0 to tell it is a command. Okay, then we made read slash write bar 0. Right, that we have done by clearing port 2.1. Then we have made enable high, that is set bit port 2.2, and we have cleared it. We are sending a high to low pulse on the port. Okay, so why did we choose this 2.0, 2.1, 2.2? Because these are the pins which have been connected in the hardware. You can see here, these are the pins which have been connected. Okay, so please use the ports that you have connected in the hardware in the program as well. Okay, if you are connected 2.0, 2.1, 2.2 in the hardware, you have to use same pins in the program also. You cannot use some other pins. Okay, if you use some other pins, when you simulate the program, when you run the program will not give any errors to you. It will work. There will not be any syntax error. But you will not be able to get the display whatever you are expecting on the LCD. Okay, when you look at the circuit as such, your hardware seems to be okay, your program seems to be okay. Okay, program will not generate any error. If you trace the program, that will also work fine. But when you interface this, no, you will not get the expected results. So please do make sure that whatever the pins you have been using in the hardware, use the same pins in the programming also. Right? Though it looks simple, these are a few critical points which you need to remember. Right? Okay, so coming back, now you have written the given the commands to the LCD. What is the next thing you have to do? You have to send the data, right? So what is the data you want to send to the LCD? What the LCD is expected to display? Here I have given yes. Okay, say yes to everything. Okay, so move A comma Y, a call data write. Okay, then we are waiting for delay. Then we are sending E to accumulator. Okay, again we are calling data write. We are waiting for some delay, and the same thing has been done for displaying the character S as well. Okay, what is this data write? This is a subroutine. Okay, what is the algorithm of this subroutine? We have to send command to the data port. Okay, command here I mean the character pertaining to Y. Okay, and you have to say we are going to write the data. For that you have to make RS 1, okay, and you have to make read slash write bar 0 because you have to tell LCD that you are going to write the data and make enable high, right? So move A comma Y, call data write, call delay, mu a comma e call data write call delay, mu a comma s call data write call delay. Okay, and if you want, you can go back to the main program and you can change the program as per your requirement, right? So in the data write, according to the algorithm, what has to be done? So you have to, the program, whatever you have written for the command, the same program works here also, except that there we have made register select 0 to inform LCD that you have been using that register for command. Here we have to make it high to tell him that we are using the register for sending the data. All the instructions except this remains the same. Clear students, it is buy one get one free. You learn how to write the command, you will be able to write how to write the data as well. Clear? And this delay program, you can generate a delay of a few milliseconds. These numbers you can vary according to your choice. Okay, normally we do give a delay of a few 2 to 3 milliseconds, not a critical parameter, right? So this is about interfacing of LCD to 8051. So in today's class you learned where do LCD finds its application. You learned the difference between LCD and LED. Those are the various modes of displaying the information. Okay, you also learned the pin configuration of LCD. You have seen how does the LCD look like. Okay, you have understood the various commands that could be given for displaying the characters according to your requirement. You have understood how to interface LCD to 8051, right? And you have understood the algorithm, right? The process, the procedure that we need to follow whenever you want to display some characters on LCD. And the program has been written pertaining to the algorithm that has been already written, right? So students, I end this session with Swami Vivekananda's quote: take risk in your life. If you win, you can live. If you lose, you can die. Right? There is always something to learn. My best wishes to each one of you. Thanks a lot. Class, let us discuss about interfacing of stepper motor to 8051. Stepper motor is a device that translates electrical pulses into mechanical movement. It finds its applications in distress, dot matrix printers and robotics. And this is the era of robotics. And you can find robots in the field of medicine, agriculture, entertainment, process industries and in the field of hospitality. And this is a video of BMW car factory. This video for your reference. Okay. This is just to have an idea of how the industry works by using robots. And you can see here, they are able to carry equipment anyway. And it is very accurate. You can see that there is no speed mismatch. Okay. And you can see a lot of synchronization among the various robots that are being connected here. And they are able to carry this weight for an angle of 360 degrees. And this place, the chicken place, is really good. And hats off to the great engineers once the They would have spent thousands of hours in developing this, right? And they are able to work accurately without having any glitch at this point of time. Means lot of time would have been spent in designing and development, right? I wish you all will become one such design engineers in the days to come, right? Now let's move on. So in all these stepper robots, stepper motor happens to be heart of the system, right? So stepper motor has a permanent magnet which is called a rotor, and it will be surrounded by stators, right? So here we are having four coils, and the two ends of the coils are connected together and they will be connected to a common point, right? And there are a few parameters which you need to be understanding before we start writing the program for stepper motors. One is step angle, other one is steps per revolution. Step angle is the angle in which the rotor moves when one pulse is applied to the input of the stator. Okay, this is very important for us to position the stepper motor. You have seen in the previous video how the stepper motor takes the component, rotates for a particular angle and plays it. Okay, that's how that step angle is decided by this particular parameter. Okay, the steps per revolution. This is the number of step angles required for a complete revolution. Okay, so the formula here is 360 degree by step angle. You decide the step angle, divide 360 degree by step angle, that tells you the number of steps per revolution. Right? Now, so see, this is one step angle, students. Can you see? So, this is your rotor. This is what I was telling you. This is your rotor. It rotates, okay, with a particular step angle. And here we have four coils. Okay, these are the four coils and these are called stator. Right? Whenever the current passes through a particular coil, the coil gets magnetized. And once the coil gets magnetized, then it will start behaving like electromagnet. Once it starts behaving like electromagnet, what will happen? It will develop north and south polarity poles. Okay, we do know that like poles repel each other and unlike poles attract each other. Right? So once the particular coil gets energized, okay, they develop the north and south poles, and then what will happen? The rotor, which is in a particular state at a particular instant of time, cannot be in the same place, okay, because of this attraction and repulsion property. So it will move one step ahead. Right? In which direction is it moving? That depends upon the coil that is going to get energized. The coil that is going to get energized depends upon the current that you are allowing to pass through in a particular coil. Right? Now, so,
and examine some unique features.
This is a video developed by Fine Master. Okay, so this is one such video. Okay, I'll be sharing all these links with you, students. Okay, this will tell you how the current passes through this, similar to the previous video, whatever you have seen. Okay, current passes through a particular coil and the coil gets energized and the rotor rotates. Right? Now, so the stepper motor can be driven either by a full step sequence or a half step sequence. In a full step sequence, what will happen? We'll have four steps. In half step, we'll have eight steps. Okay, we are having four windings, winding A, B, A bar and B bar. Let us use the same notations throughout so that it will not have any confusion in learning the concept. Okay, so in the step 1, we are feeding 1100 to the 4 windings. Then what we do, we will feed 0110, then 0011 and 1001. It is very easy to remember. You can see that the current is going, getting, we are sending the pulses in a particular direction. We are sending pulses in a clockwise direction, right? You can see the movement here. I would have shown this by an arrow mark anyway. And similarly in the half step sequence. In the half step sequence, what we do is, we energize one coil at a time. In the next step, we energize two coils. In the third step, we energize single coil again. And the process continues. Okay, so we'll be having eight steps to energize the coils of our choice or requirement. Right? So, here see, we are energizing two coils. When we energize these two coils, you can see the current that has been flowing through the coils as well. When the current passes through the coils, what will happen? The coil gets magnetized, okay? And your rotor starts rotating according to the current that will be passing through the coils. Now, here current is passing in a particular direction and your rotor rotates in clockwise direction. On the other hand, if you are passing the current in the other direction, the rotor would have rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, this energizing of the coil, the rotation of the rotor depends upon the energizing of the coil. The energizing of the coil depends upon the pulse you are going to send through the current that you are going to send through the coils. That's why we said in a stepper motor, the electric pulses will convert the electrical energy into mechanical energy, but the rotation in case of DC motor, it will be continuous, whereas in stepper motor, it will be in steps. That is the difference, right? So we can see here, in the 0 1100 has been sent, next 0110 has been sent, next 0011 has been sent, next 1001 has been sent. Okay, when you send these pulses, particular transistors will be switched on, current will pass through this and it becomes electromagnet, it develops poles, so the rotor will rotate in the other direction. Right, this is the working principle. Now, let us understand how to interface stepper motor to 805. Okay, so here we are connecting the four coils of stepper motor to the 805. But in between we have an IC called VLN2003. The question that you can ask is, why can't you connect directly to 805? The stepper motor needs around 1 ampere of current so that it will be able to function properly. But your 8051 is able to give a current of a few milliamps. Now we need something in between which will be able to increase the current handling capability, which will be able to increase the current. Okay, so we do use drivers or buffers here to increase the current. Okay, the ULN2003 is one such buffer, rather driver, which will increase the current from few milliamps to a few amperes. Right, and here the common point has been connected to ground. It could be connected either to the ground or to the VCC. Okay, now to energize this particular coil, if at all we are connecting to ground, to energize this particular coil, we have to send one to the coils. On the other hand, if it is connected to VCC, then we have to send zero to this particular coil. Clear? Now, if at all we are sending zero here, then at port pin we have to send one and vice versa. Okay, if you can, instead of ULN2003 students, you can use other buffers also. There are various buffers that are available. You have a 7-foil-S-240, 244, etc. There are octal buffers. Okay. But the only thing that you need to see here is, what is the sourcing current of 8051? What is the current that is required by stepper motor? If the buffer that you are using here is able to take the current that has been given by 8051, and if it is able to deliver the current that is required by the stepper motor, then you can choose the buffer or driver of your choice or requirement. Right? Now, so coming to the programming part, let us write the algorithm first. Okay, first we have to initialize the port, send a particular bit pattern for the step one, then wait for a few milliseconds, then you are sending the bit pattern for step two, and you'll be sending the bit pattern for step three, you'll be sending bit pattern for step four, you'll be waiting for certain duration in between. Okay, we are waiting for a duration of 5 milliseconds. Now the question is, why do we need to wait here? See, we are dealing with mechanical devices, electromechanical devices. Their speed will be different compared to the speed of the microcontroller. Right? We cannot expect the devices to work at the pace of microcontroller. Right? So what do we need to do? We should make microcontroller to wait for some time so that they will be able to cope up with the speed. Okay? The speed mismatch could be taken care of. Right, that's the reason we give a duration of 5 milliseconds. Right, so if I convert this algorithm into program, okay, this is a program in which we are going to run the stepper motor continuously in a clockwise direction. What is the bit pattern we are expected to send? C, 6, 3, and 9. Okay, and in between we have to wait for certain duration. We are expected to wait for a duration of 5 milliseconds. Okay, so we are sending 0C to stepper. Stepper has been equated to port 1, means port 1 we are sending 0C. Why are we sending to port 1? Because port 1 is the port which has been connected to stepper motor. Okay, students, I always say hardware and software go hand in hand. Okay, if at all you are using port 1 here, you have to use port 1 in the program also. It is not that I use port 1 in the hardware and port 2 in the software. Okay, as I had told you in the previous class, the prog when you run the program will not generate any syntax error. Okay, at the same time your hardware also looks fine. Okay, but when you run the program on the hardware, you will not get the expected results. Right? So please make sure that whatever you have been using in the hardware, the same thing has been used in the program as well. This is the point that you always need to remember. Right? Now, you are sending 0C to port 1. You are waiting for a duration of 5 milliseconds. Then you are sending the next bit pattern, that is 06. Then you are sending the third bit pattern 03. And then the last bit pattern 09. Okay? When you send this particular bit pattern, what will happen? The coil gets energized. You are sending through the port. It will pass through the buffer to the coils. The coil gets energized. Once coil get energized, they will become magnet. Once they become electromagnet, the rotor will start rotating. This is for the stepper motor to rotate continuously. Okay. On the other hand, if I want that to stop after one rotation, then what do I need to do? So here, we know that each step angle is 1.8 degrees. And one full rotation means 360 degrees. Is it not? Means it has to run for 200 steps. Right? So that you will be able to generate, you will be able to make the stepper motor to rotate for one particular rotation. So what have we done here? We have loaded R1 with a count. Okay? And we are sending the bit pattern through the port as usual. And we will be doing this process till the register R1 becomes 0. Once R1 becomes 0, the stepper motor will stop. That will be after one rotation. Right? Okay. Now, this is about 4-step sequence. If at all I am having 8-step sequence, okay, this is the bit pattern, right? So initially it is very easy to remember, students. See here, in 0-step you are having A, B being energized, next B and A bar, next A bar and B bar, this will be energizing B bar and A bar, okay? At the same time, we are energizing B here, then we are energizing A bar, then we are energizing B bar, then A. Okay, this is the sequence that we are energizing. Okay, here when we are energizing these two coils, it will be between A and B, then it will go to B. Okay, if you look at the diagram, then it will be between B and A bar, then it will go to A bar, then it will be between A bar and B bar, then it will go to B bar. This is how the rotation takes place. Right? Okay, here is the program. So this is the bit pattern. We have to send this pattern through the port. Right? So we are sending C, then we are sending 4, 6, 2, 3, 1, 9 and 8. Okay, these bit patterns are sent through port 1 with a delay of 5 milliseconds. Right? And the delay program has been written here as a subroutine. Okay? So this is the end of the topic. Okay, here are a few problems that have been given to you. Right, so you have to write a program to rotate the stepper motor one rotation in anti-clockwise direction with 8-step sequence. For this, what you need to do is, instead of starting from this pattern, you have to start from this particular pattern. Okay, just change the sequence. Okay, so the first pattern that you are going to send will be 1000, next will be 1001, the third will be 0001, like that it continues. Okay. For the second question, write a ALP to rotate stepper motor, two rotations in clockwise direction and five steps in anti-clockwise direction. You need to have two counters, one for clockwise direction, other one for anti-clockwise direction. You send the bit pattern two times in the port. Okay, for clockwise direction, five times through the port for anti-clockwise rotation. Right? So write a stepper motor to write a program to rotate the stepper motor for an angle of 45 degree in clockwise direction. First you decide the bit pattern. Okay, so for, you know that for 200 degree, for 360 degree 200 is the number of steps. For 45 degree, what is the number of steps that you have to initialize the counter with? Okay, you find out that, initialize the counter with that value, that will fulfill the requirement. Right? I'll stop at this. The remaining programs will be just like the other, okay, which has been learned by now. So A little knowledge that acts is worth infinity more than much knowledge that is idle. It's said by Gudram. Okay, whatever the knowledge you have acquired, students, please use it for application. Whatever the knowledge we have acquired, students, I request you all to use the knowledge that you have acquired for application. Let us work together. Okay, you are the youth of the nation. India is a promising country, developing country. Thank you, please. You people are expected to reach higher heights in the days to come.